Okay, so if you see all these checks, the total if you add 1500 plus 2500 and the balance, that is 2000, they were all given before 31st December. So that is why we entered 6000 here. So what he is telling? He is telling these checks, that is 1500 and 2500, were entered in the passbook after 31st December. That is, they were entered in January. So, but we should be concerned what happened on 31st December. So, as a result, we assume as of 31st December is concerned, 2000 is entered in the passbook. So, how to understand this? So, let us split this 6000 into the denominations what he gave. He gave us 1500 and 2500. He said balance. The balance means here it comes to 2000. He is telling these two amounts were not entered in the passbook on this date. Why? Because they were entered in January. So that is why we strike out what is common. So 2000 is common in both. We strike it out. So what is left over there? 4000 is left over there. So let us now conclude the treatment for that 4000. So it states, if you see here, you have entered 4000 on the payment side of your cash book. So the cash book balance will come down, but opposite is the passbook balance. It will increase. So if you say it will increase by 4000 on this date. So that is what. So when it is increasing, you add. So write the same statement, and or for your convenience, I'll say checks. If you want to write it in a simple or short way, you say checks issued but not presented for payment. Or you can say three checks issued, two checks not presented for payment. So you have to just write the meaning of whatever is the transaction given in the shortest possible way. So here we have to add this amount of how much? 4000. Now that is how you treat your transaction C. Now moving on to transaction D. So before we move, I'll remove this amount to avoid the confusion. Now, next it states that bill discounted got dishonored. So look for where is dishonor of bill receivable discounted. Here it is an entry in the passbook. So since it is a single amount, we need not worry much. So you have an entry on the payment side of your passbook. And when an entry is there on the payment side of passbook, the passbook balance comes down. As a result, you are finding out passbook balance. So directly you can say passbook balance is coming down by 750. Because it is coming down, you'll minus 750 in your solution. So transaction D, you can write the same statement and write 750 in the minus column. Now next transaction, that was E, it states that a check of 400 was credited in the passbook. So he's telling some amount is credited in the passbook. So when you credit an amount means it is entered in the passbook on receipt side. So passbook balance will increase. You are finding out passbook balance only. He clearly told no entry was made in the cash book. So as a result, we say passbook balance is increasing by how much? It is increasing by 400. So when it is increasing, you will add. So here for transaction E, the 400 should be entered in plus column. Now the last transaction, that is F, it states that uncredited check. The meaning of uncredited check means you have deposited a check in the bank. Bank people did not still enter it into the receipt side of your passbook. That means an entry is made by you on the debit side of cash book for this. As a result, the entry should come here. Still the bank people did not do. So how much it is? So you have entered 1000 here. So cash book balance goes up, passbook balance comes down because it is not yet entered. So because it is coming down, you will minus. So enter this 1000 here. Now let us total both the sides and this. So as we totaled, the plus column total came to 29,900 and the minus column total comes to 6,140. So as a result, take the total which is more on both the sides, 29,900. So 29,900 minus 6,140 is 23,760. That is the balancing figure. So this is the balance of the passbook which you are finding out. Since the plus column total is more, we simply say balance as per passbook. So we will do the next problem.